Hello, we are Team A and we are about to present to you a project on human activity recognition. 2 years back in 2014, the global wearable device market size was valued at $3.9 billion. With advancement and groundbreaking research in the IoT and health industry, the rate is expected to grow at 28% over the forecast period. US citizens are becoming more aware about health-related issues, and 1 in 5 Americans now own a wearable device as per a 2014 PwC report. By 2020, a projected 285 million health devices will be active. The implications of this project are tremendous, and as a part of a problem statement, we aim at accurately classifying human activities into 5 classes: sitting, sitting down, standing, standing up, and walking. Determine how long it takes to change from one activity to another and find new change points, and also find out the best wearing location to wear an accelerometer. An initial exploratory analysis of our data, the three main classes have sufficient data, but transition activities like sitting down and standing up have less data. Data was collected from 4 healthy users over a period of 8 hours, and the data points for women are more as compared to that of men. Our approach included initial classification on raw data, preparing additional accelerometer features, carrying out principal component analysis, and further refining activity detection. Since our problem comprised of multinomial classification, we tested the knife base, k-nearest neighbors, and random forest classifiers on raw data. We found out k-nearest neighbors giving highest accuracy of 67%. The optimal value of k was found to be 17 after training the data on 3 users and testing it on 1 to avoid overfitting or underfitting of the data. We went on to further analyze the model on user-independent attributes, purely based on accelerometer data, and found it to be slightly better. All future analysis was conducted on the user-independent dataset. To better understand change in activity patterns, we fabricated the role, pitch, and normal of accelerometer data, along with their mean and standard deviations. Since class variations are very drastic in nature, we decided to exploit the temporal nature of time series data by rolling up the data to overlapping sliding windows of size 5 and 11 and non-overlapping sliding windows of size 6 and 12. Due to the feature engineering of 4 accelerometers, the size of attributes increased from 19 to 56. Since accelerometer data is numeric, we decided to perform principal component analysis for dimensionality reduction and save computational cost for further classification. We retained the top n components that reflected 80% of variance of the original dataset, in our case 8 components. We observed that non-overlapping sliding window of size 6 was the best performing model. We further went on to create non-overlapping sliding windows of size 18 and 33, but the accuracy further decreased, thereby having the non-overlapping sliding window of size 6 as a benchmark model for further classification analysis. As far as the classification accuracy for a single accelerometer device is concerned, the accelerometer worn on left thigh performed the best. If a combination of 2 accelerometers is to be considered, the ones worn on waist and right arm performed the best together. This graph shows raw accelerometer data plotted. It is very difficult to observe a change point currently. However, the normal of accelerometer was reliably able to detect 11 out of 16 change points in the original dataset. The accelerometer worn on waist provided the best change point detection with a latency of 1.8 seconds. As a summary of our findings, the activity of an individual can be correctly predicted from the given accelerometer data with 77% accuracy using the k-nearest neighbor model. Additional features such as pitch, normal, and roll helped in exploiting the temporal nature of the data. Change point was reliably detected by the accelerometer worn on waist using the normal of acceleration. Even though the left thigh accelerometer performed well during the classification accuracy, we would trade off on generalization over the accuracy since the waist accelerometer provided a better change point detection. Ultimately, the best position to wear an accelerometer would be the waist, and a combination of 2 accelerometers would be the waist and right arm. As our short-term recommendations, use the k-nearest neighbors model to accurately classify human activities. For data collection, ask test subjects to wear accelerometers on their waist. Collect data for more than 4 users over a span of few days rather than few hours for better identifying transition classes like sitting up and standing down.
use advanced machine learning techniques like hidden Markov models to boost accuracy further. Thank you for watching.